Yellow Long, the bane of Web Hollow. Many players consider him to be in the top 5 hardest boss and top 3 reasons for the increase in sales of Xbox controller. The hardest boss, of course, would be Elang Shen. Scorpion King occupies number 2, and the number 3 spots is shared between either Yellow Long or Yin Tiger. In this video, I wanted to share a build and some timing strategies that I consider the best and would give you the highest chance of beating Dragon Boy without contributing to Xbox revenue. We start off where all great stories start. Which stick is the best to bludgeon someone to death? Up to this point of the story, there really is only one option for Luxus over there, the cheating staff. This staff offers the highest damage, an extra 5 critical chance and health recovery when consuming focus point after a heavy attack. As written in my motto always, you ain't dealing damage if it's not maximum damage. Killing is important, but survive to kill another day is just as crucial. Wukong had achieved Vajra's body, which make him impervious to nearly all weapons. But we are just his pubic hair, so we are gonna need some kick-ass armors to protect ourselves. And what better armor set is there other than the Gilgard Beast? This set not only provides an absurd amount of defense, a whopping 200 at early chapter 4, but also offers one up, if not the best passive. Whenever you successfully execute a perfect dodge, you gain a considerable amount of focus, and it even comes with a spell cooldown reduction. Combining with Smash Stand for focus attack, and you have the golden ratio. This set is even better than the majority of mythical armors. Only the Wukong and Bu King sets are better, and those two cannot be obtained until much later on. For the Kyrio, we are going all in on survivability. Stack as much defense in as possible. You can't deal damage if you are a corpse. I am at level 61 only, so the spell arsenal I have is limited. We go all in on Smash Stand for that Nutcracker 4 focus point. Skyfall Strike is useless with Dragon Boy, so we go big or we go home. We don't do Pillar Stand or Thrust Stand here. No pussy allowed. Any leftover spark can be dumped into Immobilize, and your choice between Giga Chat Rock Solid and Vegan Boy Cloud Staff. My choice of spirit is the screw it, Ice Bat. The bat will freeze Dragon Boy for a solid 5 seconds. 5 precious free damage seconds. Oh, but a warning, do not upgrade the bat. For some inexplicable reason, you can't freeze Dragon Boy anymore if you upgrade this spirit. Maybe upgrade increase the shine, but decrease the cold. The final piece in the puzzle is the Wind Tamer for that insane boost in damage reduction. Witness Wind Tamer in all its glory. Without the wind slowing down that spear, I lost 75% of HP, but with the wind, he barely scratched my glorious body. It's go time! Except for the first time, every subsequent fight, Dragon Boy will open with the same combo. Every single time it is the rush attack, followed by a swipe. Then he would do a vertical slash 3 hits combo. The vertical slash combo can be easily dodged by observing when he raises his spear up, count up to 2 and dodge, followed by 2 quick dodge in succession. The timing for this combo is always the same. Later on, when he is below 50%, he would add a sky landing at the end of the combo, but that is pretty obvious to dodge. His horizontal swipe combo, the first and third attacks are fake out. Those do not actually deal damage. The first spin lure you to dodge into the actual damage second attack, while the third spin wastes your time dodging, which by the time you finish, he has already started another combo. You only need to evade the second slash, then hit him on the third to flinch and interrupt his flow. The most damaging combo of Dragon Boy is the Lightning Rush. There are 3 versions of this combo. The first one is when Yellow Long health reach 80% minimum. This one is a 4 combo rush. The first hit takes only 1 second to execute. The second and third hits are 1.5 and 2 seconds respectively. And the final hit is 3. He sometimes mix up the timing of the second and third hits. observe his arm to catch the timing. The open arm animation is quicker than the wind up. Later on, when his HP decreases to 60%, he will add one hit to the combo. And when it is 40% and below, he will add another 2 hits to make it a 7 combo hits. The animation of the other attacks are quite obvious. We should focus instead on the first to third attacks. The timing would be 1, 1.5 and then 2 seconds. 50% so now should be a 5 hits attack. When he touched down, he will never attack you right away. Don't panic and spam the roll button. Use this time to heal or think of your next move. Try to get yourself into the habit of glancing at your stamina bar whenever there's a few seconds of break. When he does not attack, quickly glance at your stamina bar to assert how much is left and when we should stop the combo to spare enough stamina for a dodge. Dealing damage is important, but you can't deal damage if you are a dead man. Rock Solid is a great way to interrupt his combo while building up focus. However, be extra cautious of the follow-up because most of the time, after a parry, Yellow Long would immediately use the light thrust attack with the tail end of his spear. That attack might seem harmless, but it is actually a devastating animation lock. Also, there's a reason I prefer Smash Stand more than Pillar or Thrust Stand, other than the fact that I am not gay. It's because the focus gain while perfect dodge would enable the Nutcracker fairly quick that out DPS the other two stands. Pillar Stand can be seamlessly woven into a combo while Thrust Stand just don't have enough kick in the nut kind of feeling. Alright, about 30% left. Now the Rush combo will have 7 hits in total. The first 3 are the same, but this time, hit number 4 is extremely fast. Just 1 second wind up. Then he will continuously plunge toward you 3 more times. All of them are second tempo dodge. If you really want, using Shadow Clone Jutsu around this time is perfect. His HP is low enough and he just executes the 7 Lightning Rush, so the chance of him using it again would be low. The extra damage from the clone, though not upgrade, can still be the difference between winning and losing. But be warned, you won't have enough mana for another Immobilize if you choose Shadow Clone Jutsu. And this is something I noticed. I can't say it is 100% true, but whenever I use Shadow Clone, every boss becomes much more aggressive and they start using wide range attack much more often. Is it just me or anyone else also see that? Am I crazy? Oh my god! He just won't stop! Please! Stop! Take a deep breath! Hydrate yourself! You might not need it, but I do! And why is my voice high-pitched like this? Thank you for watching. I hope this video helps you beat Yellow Long to continue the journey. If it is helpful, please consider like and subscribe to the channel. I would really appreciate it. For now, I will see you in the next one. Valdor over and out.